Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Amen. πάντοτε νυν και ει και εις αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν. Αμωμή εν οδό αλληλούια. Ευλογήτως η Κύριε, διδαξών με τα δικαιώματα σου. Αλληλούια.
Ασάλις να μπαίνει ο δεστρών, desire forever to bear your truth. Αλληλούια.
Ενίσταξεν η ψυχή μου από ακηδείας, βεβαίωσον με εν της λόγης σου. Αλληλούια.
Ήρεμα φεύγωτ ιο τεσταμένης εν ευενό του γκρίδινες. Αλληλούια.
Αθυμία κατέσχεμε από αμαρτωλών των εγκαταλείμπανων των νόμων σου. Alleluia.
I am a true companion of all who love and fear you and keep and honor your commandments. Alleluia.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιώ και Υιώ Πνεύματι.
Νυν και Υιώ και εις αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν.
Alleluia.
But upon your great mercy, we pray to hear us and have mercy.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Again we pray for the repose of the soul, our sons of God, and Maria, who has fallen asleep, and for the forgiveness of all the errors, both voluntary and involuntary.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
That the Lord God will place his soul with the righteous rest and will grant to the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and the forgiveness of all his sins. Let us ask of Christ, the mortal King and God.
Grant this, O Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For you are the resurrection, the life, and the repose of the departed sons of God. Amelia, who is one asleep, O Christ, our God, and to your glory, together with your beginningless Father, and your holy, good, and laughing Spirit, now and always, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Εχείρε σου επίσαν με και πλάσαν με. Συνέτησόν με και μαθήσω με τα σέντολά σου. Ελέησόν με, Κύριε.
After thus I once can never be abandoned, I've not forgotten your rules of life. Be merciful to me, O Lord.
Από των κρυμάτων σου ουκ εξεκλίνα, ότι εσύ ενομοθέτησας με, ελέησον με, Κύριε.
I'm your servant for your rules of life and I've always sought. Be merciful to me, O Lord.
Έκλεινα την καρδία μου, του πείσε τα δικαιώματά σου εις τον αιώνα διανταμείψην. Ελέησον με, Κύριε.
My Lord, for you to act the time is upon us, for they have transgressed your law. Be merciful to me, O Lord.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιώ και Υιώ Πνεύματι.
Εν ειν και εις αιώνας των αιώνων. Αμήν.
Ελέησον με, Κύριε, Κύριε.
Ελέησον με, Αλληλούια. Επίβλεψον επ' εμέ και ελέησον με κατά το κλίμα των αγαπώντων το όνομα σου. Αλληλούια.
Νεότερος εγώ ημί και εξουδενωμένος τα δικαιώματα σου και πελαθόμην. Αλληλούια.
My pleading voice, hear my Lord in your great mercy and in your justice grant me life. Αλληλούια.
Άρχοντες κατεδίωξαν με δωρεάν και από τον λόγον σου εδηλίασεν η καρδία μου. Αλληλούια.
Let my soul live and its appraisal your ordinances shall assist me. Αλληλούια.
Επλανήθη ως πρόβατος απολωλών, ζήτησον την δούλην σου, ότι τα σέντολά σου ούκε πελατόμην.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, δίδαξον με τα δικαιώματά σου, τον Αγίον ο χορός ευρε πηγήν της ζωής και θύραν παραδείσου. Ευλοκαγώ την οδόν δια της μετανοίας, το απόλολος πρόβατον εγώ ημί, ανακάλεσέ με σωτήρ και σώσονε.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, δίδαξον με τα δικαιώματά σου, ο πάλεμεν εκ μειών των πλάσας με και εικόνη σου θεία τιμήσας. Παρά βάση εντολής δε πάλι με επιστρέψας, εις γυναίξης ελήφθην. Εις το καθομοίο συνεπανάγαγε, το αρχαίον καλώς αναμορφώσαστε.
Blessed are you, Lord, teach me your rules of life. Icon am I of your ineffable glory, even though the marks of sin are on me. Take pity, Lord, on your own creation, and cleanse me in your compassion. And my cherished amen do you grant to me, making me again a citizen of paradise.
Ευλογητός η Κύριε, διδαξόν με τα δικαιώματά σου, ανάπαυσον ο Θεός την δούλην σου και κατάταξον αυτήν εν παραδείσο, όπου χωρεί τον Αγίον Κύριε και οι δίκαιοι εκλάμψου συνοσφωστήρες, την και κοιμημένη δούλην σου ανάπαυσον παρορών αυτής πάντα τα εγκλήματα.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, the triumphs of the Godhead singleness, let us praise reverently chanting. Holy are you, the beginningless Father, the co-beginningless Son, and the Holy Spirit. Shine upon us who in faith worship you, and deliver us all from the eternal fire.
Και νυν και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων, αμήν. Χαίρεσαι μνή, η Θεόνς αρχιτεκούσα εις πάντων σωτηρίαν. Διείς γένος των ανθρώπων εύρατο την σωτηρίαν. Δια σου ευρημέν παράδεισον, Θεοτό και αγνή ευλογημένη.
Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God.
Alleluia, 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 δόξα σοι ο Θεός.
Alleluia, 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 δόξα σοι ο Θεός.
Μετά Μαραίνεται και όσον αρπαρέρχεται και διαλύεται πας άνθρωπος. Πάλιν δε ηχούσις τη σαρπιγκός, νεκρίος εν σύσσισμο, πάντες αναστήσονται προς την συνυπάντηση Χριστέ ο Θεός. Τότε δέσποτα ειν μετέστησας εξ ημών, εν δες των Αγίων σου κατάταξον σκηνές, το πνεύμα της εις δούλης Χριστέ.
Woe is me, what agony does the soul endure when it is separated from the body. Woe is me, how many tears it then sheds, that finds no one to come to its mercy. It turns its eyes to angels pleadingly, but its supplications go unheeded. It stretches out its hands to its fellow men, but finds no one to come to its aid. Therefore, my beloved brethren, realizing the shortness of life, let us ask of Christ's rest for the departed and for our souls his great mercy.
Πάντα ματαιότιστα ανθρώπινα, όσα όχι υπάρχει μετά θάνατον. Ού παραμένει ο πλούτος, ού συνοδεύει δόξα. Επελθόν γαρο θάνατος, ταύτα πάντα εξυφάνιστε. Διο Χριστό το αθάνατο βασίλη βοήσομεν, την μεταστάσαν εξ ημών, ανάπαυσον, εν θα πάντων εστίν, εφρενωμένον η κατοικία.
Indeed, how awesome is the mystery of our death, as the soul is forcibly separated from its harmonious union with the body, and of the coexistence's natural bond is broken by divine will. Therefore, we implore you, give rest to the parted one, the dwelling of the righteous, O giver of life, and lover of mankind.
Που έστειν η του κόσμου προσπάθεια, που έστειν η των προσκέρων φαντασία, που έστειν ο χρυσός και ο άργυρος, που έστειν τον ηκετών η πλημμύρα και ο θόρυβος, πάντα κόνης, πάντα τέφρα, πάντα σκιά, αλλά δεύτε βοήσομεν το αθανάτο βασιλή Κύριε των αιωνίων σου αγαθών αξίωσον την μεταστάσαν εξ ημών αναπαύων αυτήν εν τη αγύρω μακαριότητη.
I brought to mind the prophet who cried, I am earth and dust. And again I looked in the graves and beheld the naked bones and said, To whom could these belong, king or soldier, rich or poor, righteous or sinner? But give rest to your servant, O Lord, among the just as a just and a gracious, as a gracious and a loving God.
Αρχή μη και υπόστασης, το πλαστούργο σου γεύωνε πρόσταγμα. Βουληθείς βάρεξα ώρα τούτε και ώρα της μεζών συμπήξε φύσεως. Γήθεν μου το σώμα διέπλασας, δε δοκάς δε μη ψυχή. Τη Θεία σου και ζώπιο εμπνεύσει, διό Χριστέ την δούλην σου εν χώρα ζώντο. Έσκηνες δικαίων ανάπαυσον. Ανάπαυσον σωτήρι μόν ζωοδότα, ειν μετέστησας αδελφήν ημών, εκ των προσκέρων κράζοντα κράζουσαν δόξαση.
In your image and likeness you created man in the beginning, and you placed him in paradise to rule over your creatures. But deceived by the envy of the devil, he tasted of the fruit and became a violator of your commandments. Therefore you condemned him to the earth from which he came, Lord, to entreat you for eternal rest.
Φρυνώ και οδύρωμαι όταν εννοήσω τον θάνατον και είδω εν της τάφης κειμένην την κατοικώνα Θεού, πλαστήσαν ημίν ωραιότητα, άμορφον άδοξον διέχουσα είδος. Ω του θαύματος, τι το περί μας, τούτο γέγονε μυστήριον. Πώς παρεδόθη μεν τη φθορά και συνεζεύθη μεν το θανάτο. Όντως Θεού προστάξει, ως γεγραπτέ του παρέχοντος της μεταστάσει την ανάπαυση.
Δόξα Πατρί και Υιό και Αγίω Πνεύματι, ως θάνατος σου Κύριε Αθανασίας γέγονε προξενός, ημί γαρεμνήματι κατετέθης, ούκαν ο παράδεισος είναι οκτώ, διότι μεταστάσαν ανάπαυσον ως φιλάνθρωπος.
Και νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων αμήν, Αγνή Παρθένε του Λόγου πύλη, του Θεού ημών μήτυρ, οικέτευε, ελεήθηνε την ψυχήν αυτής.
Remember us, Lord, in your kingdom. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they revile and persecute you, and sow kinds of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven.
Εν τη βασιλεία σου μνήστη τίμων, Κύριε, μακάρι πτωχή το πνεύμα, διότι αυτόν εστίν η βασιλεία των ουρανών. Μακάρι πενθούντες ότι αυτοί παρακληθήσονται, μακάρι πραείς ότι αυτοί κληρονομήσουσι την γη. Μακάρι πεινώντες και διψώντες την δικαιοσύνη, ότι αυτοί χορταστήσονται. Μακάρι ελεήμονες, ότι αυτοί ελεήθησονται. Ληστήν του Παραδείσου, Χριστέ πολίτην, επί σταυρώσι βοήσαντα, το μνηστητή μου προαπηργάσω. Αυτού της μετανοίας, αξίωσον καμέ τον ανάξιον.
Μακάρι σ' αφαιρεί την καρδία, ότι αυτοί των Θεών όψονται. Ζωής ο κυριεύων και του θανάτου, εν τες αυλές Αγίων ανάβασον, τον προσελάβου ετών προς καιρός. Τον αμνηστητή μου, όταν έθεσαν τη βασιλεία σου.
Μακάρι να πει ότι αυτοί Θεού κληθήσονται, ότων ψυχών και ζώων, των δεσπόζων και των σωμάτων, που εν διχειρεί πνοήμων των κρύβομενων παραμυθία, ανάπαυσον εν χώρα δικαίων, είμαι
τες της αθόλης
σου.
Μακάρι δυμένε και δικαιοσύνης, ότι αυτόν έστειν η βασιλεία των ουρανών. Χριστός σε αναπαύσει εν χώρα δόντων, και πίνε παραδείσου ανήκτηση, και βασιλείας δείξει πολίτη, και άφεσιν σιδόη ονήματες, εν θεοφιλό Χριστέ.
Μακάρι εστέ όταν ανηδίσωσιν ημάς και διώξωσι και είπωσι παν πονηρό ρήμα καθημών, ψευδόμενοι ένε και νεμού, εξέλθομεν και είδομεν εν της τάφης, ότι γυμνά ως Θεά ο άνθρωπος, σκολίκων βρώμα και δυσοδεία, και γνώμεν της ο πλούτος, το καλός ίσχυς και η ευπρέπεια.
Και καλιάστε μισθώσιμον πολύ εν τη ουρανή. Ακούσαμε τι κράζει ο παντοκράτορ. Βέει ζητούντε θεάσαστε την φοβεράν ημέραν κυρίου. Αυτή γαρέ τη σκότω πυρίγαρ.
Δοκιμάσει τα σύμπαντα.
Δόξα πατρί και ο κύριο πνεύματι. Ανάρχο και γεννήσετε και πρόζω. Πατέρα προσκυνώ τον γεννήσαντα, Υιόν δοξάζω τον γεννηθέντα. Υμνώτος είναι κλάβων, πατήτε και Υιό Πνεύμα Άγιον.
Και νυν και αή και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων αμήν, πως εκ μαζών σου γαλαβρείς Παρθένε, πως τρέφεις τον τροφέα της κτήσεως, όσοι δεν οπήγας ασίδωρ εκ πέτρας, τα σκλέβας των υδάτων, διψώντι το λαό καθώς γεγράπτε.
Blessed always be the road that you travel on today, because for you has been prepared a place of eternal rest.
Μακαρία η οδός
on my own authority, as I hear, as my judgment is just, because I do not seek my own will.
Glory to you,
the Father who sent me.
Glory to you, O Lord. Glory to you.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the power of the souls and the good Amalias who are asleep, and for the healings of all the areas, both voluntary and involuntary.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
True God, who place your soul with the righteous wisdom, who grant to the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and the forgiveness of all the sins that are sought for Christ, the mortal King and God.
Grant this, O Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God, whose spirit and all flesh were stamped on death, crushed the power of the devil and granted life to your world, do yourself, O Lord, give rest to the soul of the departed son of God, Amalia, who has fallen asleep in a place of light,
Amen.
A place of green pasture,
Amen.
A place of repose,
Amen.
Where there is no grief, sorrow or mourning.
Amen.
Forgive every sin which he has committed in word or deed or thought, for you are a good God who loves mankind. For there is no one who lives and does not sin, only you are such sin. Your righteousness is an everlasting righteousness. Your word is truth.
Amen.
For you are the resurrection, the life, and the power of the departed sons of God, Amalia, sworn asleep, O Christ our God, and to ascribe glory together with your beingless Father, and you with holy, good, and lofty spirit, now and always, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to our God, our glory to make Christ our true God, who rose from the dead, and has dominion over the living and the dead, as immortal King, through the intercessions of his most pure and undefiled Mother, of the Holy Ghost, all praise the apostles, of our holy and God-bearing fathers, of the holy and glorious forefathers Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, of his holy and righteous friend Lazarus, his 4 days in the tomb of all the saints, the sons of the living place of the righteous, the soul of his servant Amalia, who has departed from among us, granted rest in the bosom of Abraham, Amen, a number among the righteous,
Amen,
and may he also have mercy upon us,
Amen,
and save us. Who is a good and merciful God who loves mankind.
Amen.
May your memory be turned over, blessed and ever, sister in Christ. May your memory be turned over, blessed and ever, sister in Christ.
She don't know what to say. There are no words for this. There are no words to describe the cavernous emptiness, the vacuous hole sucks at my inside when the thought creeps into my consciousness that she's dead. I won't smell the faint fragrance of face powder and lipstick as I lean into her grin, and in doing so smell all the sensitive security that she brought to my childhood.
I won't see her roughly, gentle, arthritic hands that sat like restless birds in her lap, waiting for another domestic directive. I won't hear her calling me my darling again, or the peculiar and precious way she said my name. There are no words to describe the acrid, bitter taste of regret that I didn't visit her one more time and tell her one more time how much I loved her and what she meant to me. There will be no more times because she is gone. I drove through Parkview a number of times last week. I drove up and down Galway Road, the road of my childhood and of my children's childhoods. I parked outside number 60, while the memories dropped down delicately like the jacaranda flowers outside her home there. I remember her connecting me from Macaulay House every day, the relief of seeing her there because it meant the school day was done, the excitement of climbing into the car and guessing what was for lunch by the smell of her clothes, and the comfort of knowing that we had an afternoon of baking or knitting ahead. I remember the way it felt when she hugged me and the way her cracked, chapped fingers felt in my hair. I remember her dogmatic dedication to Papu, bringing him something to drink when he demanded it, fussing about him and pandering to his every need. I remember her patience with me and her subtle sense of fun, afternoons in the swimming pool dunking her perfectly coiffed head into the water when she wasn't expecting it, or almost pulling her down with me when this tenacious and tiny woman held my hand as I clumsily careered down the road to the park in my roller skates. I remember sitting on the shiny slasto patio in the sun, licking freshly made tarama off my fingers while she tirelessly tended and watered her precious garden. I remember sitting at her dressing table, putting on her makeup, and her letting me wear her green ring and try on her shoes, and prancing in front of that full-length, white, ornate mirror in her bedroom, feeling almost as much of a proper lady as she was. She was always immaculately dressed and perfectly groomed, and I always felt so proud of my grandmother when she attended any of my school functions or any of my children's parties. Sorry. I remember all her food and all her baking. The gloriously gluttonous aromas that emanated from that kitchen were heavenly. Food was her love language, and that has been passed down to my mother, to me, and to my daughter. We love to cook. It's an expression of who we are and how we love. Yaya fed us. She fed our friends. She fed her friends. She even fed the security people at the lodge. She was a constant provider and generous to a fault. Nothing was ever too much effort. She showered us with treats and sweets and gifts, and more importantly, with love. As a young adult, I still chose to spend time with her. I'd visit her every week on my way home from varsity. When my family traveled, I stayed with her. I remember lying on the heated floor in the lounge, trying to study for exams and struggling to stay awake, while she patiently knitted on the couch next to me. She'd keep me company till I went to bed, which was often after midnight. She'd then wake me up at 5 a.m. as requested with tea, gently cajoling me and having to crowbar me out of bed, reminding me what section I still needed to revise. She'd kiss me goodbye on the kitchen step and wish me luck. She'd tell me she was proud of me and that she loved me. And then she'd ask me what I wanted for dinner that night. She also had a mischievous sense of humor and pervasive persuasion techniques. Given enough time, she could convince you to do anything and even make you feel like it was your idea in the first place. I remember her arriving back from Greece one year and showing Andrew the shoes that she bought for our wedding when we weren't even engaged yet. I remember staying at her for the last time the week before my wedding, hoping that one day I would become as good a woman, a wife, mother, and grandmother as she was. I remember the look of pride on her face when she looked at my children, and the shy joy that quivered on her lips when I told her my lastborn's name was Chloe Amelia. I remember the look of love on her face each time I visited her, and how she graciously thanked me each time. What I would give for just one more visit. No matter how much I prepared myself, but the words, Yaya has just died, smacked me in the face like falling into ice-cold water, taking my breath away. I'd been awake since 2 o'clock that morning, expecting that phone call. There've been so many times over the last 5 years that I thought she might leave us, but she never did. In her slightly stubborn way, she refused to go when expected to. She always fought back fiercely, but she was tired, so very tired, and bored in an almost silent and immobile world, and lonely in this crazy COVID consciousness, not comprehending why no one was visiting her. She passed away in the same way in which she lived, graciously and gently, in such a quiet, ladylike manner. A pink polka dot nightie, spotlessly clean and perfect. I know she's finally at peace now with her husband and her siblings, for whom she longed. She would not want us to be broken by our guilt or paralyzed by our grief. She would not want us to be racked with regret. She would not want us to wish that she was still with us. She would want us to love each other, to be kind to each other, and to find a way through our differences. She would want us to focus on the good in this life, to be grateful for our blessings, and to remember how much we were loved. She was the epitome of service, of provision, of ladylike appearance and behavior, and of grace. And her memory will live strong in the hearts of all those privileged enough to be loved and cared for. One of the most amazing women I have ever known. Goodbye, my lady. I thought this was too much.
Welcome and a sincere word of thanks to the family and friends that have joined us personally and online today. We are gathered here today in the memory of my mother, Amalia Stavrofotopoulos, so that together we may acknowledge and share both our joy in the gift that her life was to us and the pain that her passing brings. David Harkins wrote, "You can shed tears that she's gone, or you can smile because she has lived. You can close your eyes and pray that she will come back, or you can open your eyes and see all that she's left behind. Your heart can be empty because you can't see her, or you can be full of the love that you shared. You can turn your back on tomorrow and live yesterday, or you can be happy for tomorrow because of yesterday. You can remember her only that she is gone, or you can cherish her memory and let her live on. You can cry and close your mind, be empty and turn your back, or you can do what she would want, smile, open your eyes, love, and go on." When I pay tribute to my beautiful mother, I think of our beautiful, gracious, beloved mother in Yaya. She was the heart and anchor of our family and home, the angel of our entire family, with a simple yet powerful, unshakable faith, a servant yet a lion's heart, with Christ-like ways that were an example of a love for her family and for God. She always said to me, "Izzy, never give up. Have hope. Your miracle from God is around the corner." This is what has carried me through the many challenges that I've encountered along the way. That my mother prayed for me and helped me to have hope and belief in life and God again. My mother was my rock and anchor, my friend and confidant. She tirelessly prayed for her whole family each and every day, or waking up at 5 o'clock each morning. getting up to light her candle and begin her day. Her favorite prayer was the Lord's Prayer that she said each day, as well as the prayer of healing each day. My mother was a member of the church that we sit in today, attending church every Sunday, meeting with my Aunt Vespina and friends each week. My mother loved to chat to my Aunt Vespina and Amelia on the phone for hours each night, sharing their joys and sorrow. She lived life, with joy, with courage and determination. She had a zest for life and people, and cared for my father and tirelessly supported him in his businesses over the years. She loved her grandchildren and regularly told her friends how blessed she was to have three daughters, two son-in-laws, and grandchildren and great-grandchildren who cared for her. She loved all the cousins, many of them who are with us personally and online today. She was a master baker, taught by my father, and was known in the Lodge Retirement Village for her magnificent cakes and culinary skills. She loved her garden with a passion and sewing and read her newspaper and news daily. A special memory I have is of my mother and us three daughters going to Greece and Turkey in 2002, meeting with family and friends and her sister Irini. I think of the words of my mother. She said, "Izzy, when I am gone one day, do not grieve and mourn as the world grieves and people that do not believe in God. Know that when I die, I'm going to heaven to be with your Father, because I have accepted Christ into my heart and I have eternal life." She once reminded me of the verse of Ecclesiastes 3 verses 1 to 4. "In everything there is a season, a time for every purpose under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, and my mother's new season has come." I conclude with a poem, "Don't Grieve." Today I lift my loved ones as I go. I pray, Lord, do not let them grieve too much because I've died today. Let there be no wailing echoing the halls, the same halls that held laughter and answers to my calls. I pray that they will all take comfort, accepting the true way, and listen when I tell them these three things today. Love will be forever, a promise that will last. So love me more than even now my time with you has passed. And last of all, remember the glowing love to be when our eyes meet once again for all eternity. Goodbyes are not forever. Goodbyes are not the end. They simply mean I'll miss you until we meet again. We will miss you, Mom, yeah, until we meet again. The family would like to express gratitude to Julia Poddy, who nursed my mother for 14 years with love, dedication, and heart, as if she was her own grandmother. Vinolia Gamide, who tirelessly looked after my mother at night with dedication and care, and Veronica Saluke, who was with her the night that my mother passed away. We would like to thank the staff and frail care of the Lodge Retirement Village for their care and support of our mother. And thank you to family and friends for enriching our mother's life over the years. Thank you, and life to all of us. We will miss you, Mom, Yaya, until we meet again.
Just from our side, the service I think is full in the words that we use, and there isn't much else to say because your mother was a woman of deep faith, and as it says in the Bible, as it says, and Christ confirms to us, that whoever knows Christ knows life eternally, lives eternally, and knows that we do grieve but with hope in his mercy, in his love, and that we will always resurrect and be with God. So
you must have a lot of consolation, a lot of comfort, and in your grief and in your pain, remember the most important and the central message of the Church of God, of your mother's life, which is that Christ is erected, is trampled on death by death, and there is no more dominion over Christ from death. We now live eternally, and this is the beginning of a new chapter, of a new continuation, of something that has really started, where she almost wrote her daily exams over here, and having lived with love, having lived in its fullness, perfected and allowed the grace, sanctify and heal her, and grant her now peace, so that she can celebrate and enjoy the rest of the eternity. Father, with this invitation, give her strength. You must always have a blessing. To lose a mother is always very, very difficult. A mother's love, there's no love like a mother's love. But when we know that they've gone somewhere to rest,
they've lived a full life, had a lot of love to share and to give, and taught many of our grandchildren and children the right example, then at least, even though we grieve, we do grieve with a lot of hope, and we do grieve in a way that gives us the joy. And as it says in the poems that you read, when no one, they wouldn't want us to be grieving, actually, they would want us to smile and live our life and be more full in our joy and the things that we share with everybody around us, because we have become all the better for the love that they taught us. Christos Anesti, Panagia Maris, Ascalissima. What we normally do is we bid our last farewell. Whoever wants to can then give condolences to the family, if the family wants to, but because of the restrictions, we understand everybody's personal space. Thank you. Δεύτερον ασπάσας θέτην.